students, welcome to the Jimmy Carter National Historical Park. My name is Marley Ushery and I'm the teacher here at the park. Today we're going to take a very special tour. We're going to visit Jimmy Carter's boyhood home, where he grew up. Now I want you to think about some things as you walk through the house with me today. But before we do that, I want everybody, close your eyes. I want you to take a picture with your brain. I want you to think about your house. Think about your bedroom. Think about all the things in your house that make your life comfortable. Okay, do you have those pictures in your brain? Okay, keep them there. And as we walk through Jimmy Carter's house, I want you to notice the differences in your house and his house. Now, Jimmy Carter moved here with his family in 1928 when he was 4 years old. And he lived here until he was 17 years old. That's when he left to go to college. So if he moved here when he was 4 years old and he left here when he was 17 years old, how many years did Jimmy Carter live here with his family? Take just a minute to see if you can figure that out. That's right, he lived here for 13 years. So I am ready to take you on a really cool tour of Jimmy Carter's home and help you learn a little bit about what it was like to grow up in the 1930s. Do you still have those pictures in your brain? Because you're going to need them later when we sit down in the living room. I'm going to ask you a few questions. So let's go. Students, we're inside the house now, and the first stop on our visit is Jimmy Carter's bedroom. Now remember when I asked you to take pictures in your mind of your own bedroom? While I'm showing you Jimmy Carter's bedroom, I want you to imagine your bedroom in your mind and think about the differences in your room and the differences in Jimmy Carter's room. And we're going to talk about that a little bit later when we go and have a seat in the living room at the end of our house visit. Now, the first thing I want to tell you about in Jimmy Carter's bedroom is something that was very, very important to him, and that's the model ship you see on the top of his bookshelf. That's very important because that ship is what started Jimmy Carter dreaming about going into the Navy. That was a gift from his Uncle Tom Gordy, who was in the Navy. His Uncle Tom was his mother's brother. And his Uncle Tom and Jimmy Carter were pen pals. That means that they wrote letters back and forth to each other. I'm gonna let you in on a little secret. Jimmy Carter did not dream of being president when he was a little boy. He wanted to be in the Navy. And he did go to the Navy. But he later came home to run the family business after his father passed away. You can also see books on the bookshelf. Jimmy Carter loved to read. He loved to read books, and he would ask for books for Christmas and for birthdays. He didn't get a lot of toys like you might get. He wanted books. The books and his Uncle Tom's letters opened the world up to him, and he dreamed of traveling the world through all the things that he read. This was his bedroom from the time he was 4 years old until he turned 17 and left home to go to college. Another thing about Jimmy Carter's bedroom was it was very cold. He did not have a heater in here. And we do not have electricity in the house. It was cold in here. He did not have a fireplace. The only source of heat that he had for his bedroom actually came from across the hall, the kitchen. Now I want you to think about this just a minute. What in a kitchen would provide heat for Jimmy Carter's bedroom if it's right across the hall? So the next stop on our visit is the kitchen. Come on, let's go take a look. Remember those pictures in your mind? Now I want you to think about your kitchen at your house and let's see if it's different from Jimmy Carter's kitchen. Remember I told you how cold Jimmy Carter's bedroom was? And that right across the hall in the kitchen was something that would have provided a little bit of heat for his room. What in this kitchen do you think would have provided that heat? You're right, it's the stove. Now, I want you to think about the pictures in your mind that I asked you to take before you came into the house. Did you take a picture of your kitchen? Does it look like this kitchen? What are some things that are in your kitchen that you don't see in this kitchen? If you said a refrigerator, you're exactly right. They did not have a modern day refrigerator in this room. They did not have a coffee maker. They didn't have a microwave. They did not have these things because they did not have electricity in this house when Jimmy Carter was a little boy. They didn't have a modern refrigerator, but they did have an icebox, which is located in the breakfast room next door. Now an icebox is exactly what it says. It is a wooden box with ice in the bottom of it. They would actually put small items like milk and eggs and things that needed to keep cold, just like your refrigerator, in the icebox. Now what you probably don't see in here either is a table where they actually eat. This small table would have been used to prepare food. Connected to the kitchen is a breakfast room and a dining room. That is where the family ate. Most of their meals were eaten in the breakfast room at the small table. When they had large family gatherings or on Sundays or special occasions, they would eat in the dining room. So students, now we're going to take a look at some of the other living spaces in the house. We visited Jimmy Carter's room, but Jimmy Carter lived here with his family. So we're going to take a look at his parents' bedroom, the bathroom, and his sister's bedroom, as well as the living room, where we're going to sit down and have a chat about what we've seen today. So come on, let's go to the other rooms. Students, now I want to talk about the living spaces in the home. We visited the kitchen, the breakfast room, the dining room, and Jimmy Carter's bedroom. But of course, Jimmy Carter didn't live here by himself. He lived here with his mama and daddy, Lillian and Earl, and his three siblings, Ruth, Gloria, and baby brother Billy. Now the bedroom behind me belonged to his sisters Ruth and Gloria. They shared a bedroom. Down the hall you will find his parents' bedroom. Something very important in that bedroom is the baby crib. This is where his youngest brother Billy slept. Now it may look like an ordinary crib to you, but to me, it's very important because not only was that Jimmy Carter's brother, Billy, he was also my daddy. Next to the parents' bedroom was the bathroom. Now, a bathroom is an important room in the house, but this bathroom probably looks a little different from the bathroom you have in your house, especially the shower. If you look at the shower, you may notice something a little strange. Why in the world would there be a bucket hanging at the top of the shower? If you look closely underneath, you'll see some holes. Jimmy Carter's father, Mr. Earl, decided that he wanted a shower, so he made his own. He took a sharp object and a hammer. He put holes in the bottom of the bucket, and that's how they took a shower. Pretty cool, huh? The last room we're going to visit today is the family room. You may call it the den. Now, just like you gather with your family, maybe to watch TV, the Carter family gathered here to read books and listen to the radio or just to have conversation at night. A very important piece of furnishing in this room was this desk right behind me. This desk had a name. The Carter children called it Mother. They called it Mother because their mother, Miss Lillian, would often leave notes for them when she had to go out at night to nurse because she did not know if she would be back the next morning when they woke up to get ready for their day. Now, the notes on the desk were about their activities for the day, the chores they may have to do, and who knows, she may have even left a note about don't forget your homework before you go to school. Another important object in this room is the radio. Now, this radio probably looks a lot different than the radio in your home. It ran off of a battery, but not just any kind of battery. Not the kind of battery that you think of that you put in all of your games. This radio ran off of a car battery. They would hook the wires to it, and the family would listen to music programs, sports programs, and one of President Carter's favorite things to do as a little boy was to lay on the rug in front of the fire and listen to radio programs late into the evening. His daddy would let him do that as a special treat. The entire Carter family loved to read. So today, I'm going to read a book to you about President Carter and his family. So come on, let's go have a seat and I'm going to read you a story. Students, now I want to share a book with you about one of my favorite people, Jimmy Carter. You've learned a lot about his home today. This book will give you more information about his life here on the farm, his life as a politician, and his life after he was president as a humanitarian. The title of our book is Jimmy Carter, Dreamer, Statesman, Humanitarian. The first picture is a school picture of Jimmy Carter when he was 12 years old. The picture in the middle is his official presidential portrait. And this is a picture that was taken about 5 years ago of President Carter after he was president as a humanitarian. Stop and think just a moment, what is a humanitarian? If we cover up part of the word, you have human. A humanitarian is a person that does good deeds for people all over the world. President Carter is a famous humanitarian. Jimmy Carter was born on October 1st, 1924, in Plains, Georgia. No one knew at the time that he would one day grow up to be President of the United States. This is a photo of Jimmy Carter when he was a baby with his mama, Miss Lillian. When he was 4 years old, Jimmy and his family moved into this farmhouse in Archery, a small community 2 miles outside of Plains. The house was heated by fireplaces and a wood stove and did not have running water or electricity until 1938, when Jimmy was 14 years old. The Carter family lived in this house for 21 years. Until moving back to Plains in 1949. When Jimmy wasn't in school, he was expected to do chores around the farm. He helped care for the farm animals, worked in the garden and fields, and helped out in the family store. His favorite farm animal was his pet pony, Lady. When he was not doing farm chores, he liked to read, fish, fly kites, and ride his pony. His bedroom was the place where he could be alone and keep his treasures, including books, arrowheads, school trophies, and his prized possession, a model ship sent to him by his Uncle Tom Gordy, who was in the Navy. This sparked his own dream of joining the Navy and traveling the world. Family was very important to Jimmy. His father, Mr. Earl, was a wise businessman and a leader in his community. He taught Jimmy the importance of hard work and responsibility. He had three siblings, two sisters, Gloria and Ruth, and a younger brother, Billy. Jimmy's mother, Lillian Carter, was a nurse. She was respected in the community for being kind and fair. She set an example for her children by having the courage to show compassion for all people, no matter where they lived or the color of their skin. Jimmy Carter's ideas about human rights were formed during his childhood while watching his mother care for others. Another very special lady in Jimmy Carter's life was Rachel Clark, an African-American tenant farmer who lived and worked on the Carter farm. Jimmy loved to spend time with Rachel and her husband Jack, listening to stories, learning how to do farm chores, and going fishing. Even as a young boy, Jimmy knew that Rachel Clark was a very wise lady and made sure that he listened and learned when he spent time with her. Jimmy Carter was a very good student. After he finished high school, he went to college and then to the United States Naval Academy. After he graduated from the Naval Academy, he married Rosalind Smith. They have four children, three boys and one girl. After serving in the Navy for many years on a submarine, Jimmy Carter and his family returned home after his father died to run the family farming business. When he was not working in the business, he served as a leader in many organizations around his community and state. He was a natural leader and became a Georgia State Senator in 1962 and was elected Governor of Georgia in 1970. On November 2, 1976, Jimmy Carter was elected the 39th President of the United States of America. As president, he worked hard to save the environment, provide a quality education for all students, and to promote human rights and peace for people throughout the world. Since leaving office, President Carter has continued to work for peace, human rights, and a quality of life for people all over the world. In 2002, he won a Nobel Peace Prize for his humanitarian work. Boys and girls, I would like for you to read this page with me. Thank you, President Carter, for helping us learn to help others. Students, thank you for visiting Jimmy Carter's Boyhood Home with me today. I hope you have learned the differences between living in the 1930s and your home today. I hope you've enjoyed the tour today. I hope you can come see us soon in person.